Welcome to Our Lady of Fatima University, embarking for more than 50 years of journey to greater heights. To realize the vision for the college, CVA is committed to deliver the program-intended learning outcomes, utilizing the academic industry collaboration model as it promotes the achiever in producing learners who are passionate to excel, are professionally competent, and who practice social responsibility. Offers baccalaureate programs such as Bachelor of Science in Accountancy, Bachelor of Science in Accounting Information System, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, Major in Marketing Management, Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneurship. CVA continues to pursue the effective and sustained involvement in the Fatimanian community through highly anticipated events and activities such as these. Thank you. College of Business and Accountancy is committed to provide outcomes-based education as offered by the university to all its students, and is dedicated in providing quality education, eager to produce competent and preferred graduates. Our Lady of Fatima University through the College of Business and Accountancy, owning well-rounded individuals in all aspects of life, pioneers of higher learning and instilling moral values formation. Make it your college of choice and start your legacy here at the College of Business and Accountancy.
Welcome to another online episode of our Let's Connect CBA Online Kumustahan. This time, CBA Quezon City Campus naman ang kukumustahin natin. Kaya just want to say hi and hello sa lahat ng mga CBA students natin sa Quezon City Campus, lalong-lalo na ang mga marketing students natin, entrep students, accountancy students, at BSAE students or accounting information system students. Dahil live tayo ngayon sa ating CBA Val official Facebook account at live din tayo sa CBA Connect official Facebook page. At syempre live din tayo sa official Facebook page ng Our Lady of Fatima University. Kaya hi and hello din sa mga online viewers natin. At syempre, hi din sa aking partner ngayon, ang aking Ma'am BFF. Ma'am Sheila, how are you?
Hi, Sir BFF. Hello sa'yo. Good afternoon. We're in high spirits and this is CBA Quezon City Campus. Of course, we would like to say hello sa ating butihing university president who will join us later on, si Dr. Caroline Enriquez. Of course, we would like to say hi to our campus administrator, Dr. Ramonita Salazar.
Hi, Dean. How are you, Dean?
Hello din po sa ating CBA College Dean na ating technical expert po this afternoon, Dr. Cordova. Hello po sa inyo. I would also like to say hi to all our panelists this afternoon who will answer some of the questions na syempre maraming tanong yung ating mga students. Hello, of course, to our industry speaker later on. May mga tanong din ang ating mga students sa kanya. I would also like to say hello sa ating dalawang students na mag-share ng kanilang SOST Awesome Experience. So, Sir JR, chika mo naman sa akin o sa kanila, no, na bakit pa natin ginagawa itong CBA Online Kumustahan?
You know, partner, Ma'am BFF, the COVID-19 pandemic has affected educational system worldwide, leading in education systems big shift from classroom to computers. Because of this pandemic, our university reshaped our educational system that will fit to your needs by giving you, our students, with new and best solutions for education. Pak na pak ba, partner?
Yes, at dahil we understand that during such worrying time, yung ganitong panahon, and of course, disruptive time, it's natural for a lot of us, especially our students, to have questions. And later on, we will discuss those questions during the Q&A portion. We have the Q&A portion. Of course, for our students, your dreams can't wait. Hindi pwede. That's why we've got options and solutions for you to continue your education even this time of the pandemic. And may response ang CBA also to the continuity in learning, yung challenges nun.
Okay.
Kung si BDO, meron we find ways. Si Olfo naman, We've got options and solutions.
Correct, yes. No? Tama tayo dyan. Olfo got options and solutions. So bago tayo marangkada sa ating mga baliktaktakan later at mga questions ng ating mga students galing sa Q&A box natin, siguro, Dean Salazar, okay lang po ba namingyan namin kayo ng konting welcome remark? Dean?
Good afternoon.
Okay.
Good afternoon, Dean.
Hi, Dean.
Okay. Medyo mahina signal siguro ni Dean. Balikan natin si Dean later.
Oo, oh, tsaka pag live talaga ganyan.
Oo, oh, nagkakaroon no, tayo happens, ng ganyang mga internet connection problem, no? Oo. Oh, oh. Okay, partner, siguro dumiretso na muna tayo sa ating guest resource person na ating distinguished industry speaker. So, ko siyang introduce. So, may our introduction for her is she is a graduate of BS Psychology last 2014 and started working in the HR industry since then until now. Currently, she is a recruitment partner in company based in Australia and to be internship supervisor for VP of company. So it's my pleasure to introduce Ms. Patricia P. Mauricio. Ma'am BFF, alam ko meron kang sasabihin para sa kanya.
Yeah, actually, si Ms. Patricia or Ms. Tricia is already part of the CBA family. Hi, Ms. Tricia. How are you? It's been a while.
And, yes, hello.
I'm really delighted to see you and of course have you this afternoon as our industry resource speaker. Maraming matutuwa ng mga online viewers natin. Na isang taga HR department ang aming speaker this afternoon. Kasi syempre, maraming mga graduate this year and they're looking for jobs. And maraming mga graduating students soon, they will look for their host company. So, swak talaga na pasok na pasok si Miss Tricia. And Miss Tricia, if you could share with us or give us some thoughts before we entertain some questions from our online viewers and from our Q&A box. Ms. Tricia?
Sure, sure. Anyway, thank you. First, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Ms. Sheila Apostol for having me with this webinar and also all the faculty members of Our Lady of Fatima. This is actually my second time, but the first one was a face-to-face speaking agreement with you guys. So that was way back 2006 ata or 2007. And thank you so much for having me again. Now, of course, actually, when I got the invite from Ms. Sheila, I actually was really excited because, you know, it's not always that you have that opportunity that someone would speak to you and, you know, approach you to become a speaker in a seminar or in a webinar like now. So I'm very privileged to be part of this webinar. Thank you so much, everyone. Okay, so yeah, to formally start with the talk, I mean, let's get to business, you know. Yes, I actually graduated 2014 with the course of BS Psychology. And from then, I already started looking for a job that's related to my course. So mainly, when I got the invite, I actually asked myself, when I asked Sheila, she told me that it's more of how to inspire the students, how is my journey in this career. So I actually asked myself, ano ba yung matututunan ng mga estudyante na ito sa akin? If there is something that they will learn from me. And then I thought of my previous interns that actually came from Our Lady of Fatima University. And I'm very proud to say that until now, they're actually all employed. They have a great job. And I don't see that they are much affected of this pandemic. And that is one thing that I'm very, very proud about. Because, you know, tama yung sinabi ni Michelle kanina eh, your dreams cannot wait. Right? So your dreams really cannot wait. If you have the motivation, if you're really passionate about something, whatever hindrances come your way, whatever the changes or the challenges like this COVID-19 pandemic that we're facing right now, all you have to do is to move on. You know, you face your fears and do whatever it takes for you to reach your goal. So I wanted to share with you my journey in the HR industry. And hopefully, you know, the students that are watching this webinar would learn something from it. Because I truly believe that, you know, there's, I mean, realistically speaking, di ba sinasabi nga ng mga tao, it's more of the discarte. Regardless if you graduated with all the honors or all the flying colors, if you don't really push hard for yourself to get to the goal, it won't happen. So I myself, I started in the industry with no experience. And, you know, it was not that easy because during that time, there are a lot of companies already that's in the industry na very big na talaga. Right? So, and it's very hard for me to move forward, but then you won't stop till you reach your goal. And then I was able to be part of one established company, which is Concentrix Philippines. It was part of the, before it was Fortune 500 companies, but right now it's part of Fortune 1000. And that is where actually I employed all the students from Our Lady of Fatima University. Now, pointers of this seminar or this talk that I would like to imply is that first, for all the students who are, you know, thinking of enrolling because they're, you know, they feel like they don't want to continue their studies because of the pandemic, because this is something new to them, you know, I would just tell them that, you know, change is the only constant in life, right? If you won't take those changes in a positive, you know, in a positive manner, you'll stuck with whatever you have right now. May mapag-iiwanan ka. Yan yung lagi kong sinasabi sa mga previous interviews ko before. If you won't take action now, mapag-iiwanan ka. There are a lot of students here in the Philippines, maybe, or kahit sa ibang bansa. They don't have much of whatever certificate, but they are very willing to learn. They are very eager to, you know, take chances, take risk, and accept the changes that are coming their way. And that is very important. So now I would relate it to the scenario that we have right now with the COVID-19 pandemic. This is a global issue. You know, we can't do anything about it. So if I'm, let's say, for example, I'm a student and I'm thinking of not enrolling because of pandemic, and then ano na lang yung mangyayari sa'yo, right? Where in fact, I actually checked online yesterday because I wanted to check the, you know, the webinars previously from AllFu. And I was really, you know, I was really surprised to see that Our Lady of Fatima University are offering a lot of privileges to the students. And it's really good. I'm really, you know, if I'm a student, I would really take the risk to do so. Because I see that you're offering, you know, tuition fee adjustments like 20-30%. And then you're also providing like tuition fee scholarships and, you know, also some loans for the student. And that's really great, you know. If to all the students who are watching now, I would really encourage you to take the risk, you know, because all the resources are available. The books are now converted to ebooks. Your professors are there to always make sure that you're doing it great, that you're, you know, you're doing whatever that you're supposed to do. The only difference is that it's not face to face. And I don't see any problem with that. You know, every day you have to just look at the brighter side of those pictures or every scenario. Kasi remember, if you're at home, diba, with this pandemic, you don't need to spend much for your fare going to school. Right? Also, you can get to be with your family from 24/7, where in fact yung ibang mga estudyante, you know, they get to travel from house to school and then they get exhausted. So those are the positive side of this pandemic, you know, because if we're gonna rely on the negativity of this situation that we have right now, I don't think na magpo-proceed yung buhay natin ng maayos at, you know, maaliwalas. Next is, of course, acceptance is the key. Always yan, di ba? I mean, we always hear it from the elderly or from whoever people that they really inspire people. They always tell you acceptance is the key. Because right now with the COVID-19 pandemic, we can't do anything about it. Even those people na graduate ng summa cum laude, even those people, the doctors, whoever it is, they can't do anything about it. So what we can do is to take our action plan. So the action plan now is for you to continue your studies and make sure that you get to your goal. That is basically the action plan. And of course, with your motivation, your passion in studying, that's very important. And I think yun yung importante ngayon with this pandemic, because if you're going to focus on the negative side, you know, we can't, mapag-iiwanan talaga tayo. So yun nga, di ba, there was a saying actually, yeah, that you will never have a positive life with a negative mind. And mental health is very important. So right now, I think kasi realistically speaking, no, what I see with the people nowadays or with the generation is that they want to have everything in a rush. You know, they want to have a job. Mm-hmm. They want to have a, when they say, I want to graduate and then I want to get a job in the office. I want to have my own office. I want to have my desk and everything. But, you know, guys, it's not as easy as that. For you to have your name on the table, it's okay, not as easy as that. You have to work for it. And right now, if you don't want to even enroll or if you don't want to even continue your studies, paano mo ma-reach yung ganung goal mo? Right? I myself, I actually started from the bottom. And then right now, I'm part of the marketing management and one of the managers. I'm also, you know, it was never easy. And mind you, yung mga iba sinasabi nila na, I wanted to have this job because I want it for no reason. And then they're not even thinking kung ano ba talaga yung core task ng job na yun. Sometimes, maganda lang siyang pakinggan, pero the core task itself is super hirap. You know, it takes really courage, passion, everything for you to be able to be in that position. So, I guess we have to take one step at a time. If I would tell the students now that are watching, I would suggest right now, if you feel like you don't want to continue your studies, if you're feeling down, if you're not motivated with everything that's happening right now, then try to see yourself 5 years from now, right?
Okay.
If 5 years from now, that's your thinking, then sa tingin mo ba makakakuha ka ng isang trabaho na mailalagay mo yung pangalan mo sa lamesa? Right? So, yeah, I think that's the thing that I really want to share with them. And, you know, all as I've mentioned earlier, all the resources are available. You should be grateful, actually, to Our Lady of Fatima University, because not all universities are offering that privilege, right? Like the, you know, the tuition fees. Ang dami mga estudyante dyan nagkakandarapang magtrabaho, nagkakandarapang maghanap ng scholarship. And correct, right now, it's already upfront, you know? It's offered upfront. All you have to do is grab the opportunity and go get your goal. That's the thing. So, okay. Yeah, I think that's it.
Thank you, Ma'am Patricia. Ma'am Patricia, may mga questions tayo. Narito si Joshua Gomez.
Sir BFF, bitinin muna natin yung
correct.
Alam ko, merong mga pumasok na questions.
Yes.
Agad, kasi syempre, very interesting and very inspiring din yung mga thoughts.
Sobrang interesting nga. Sobrang interesting na talk ni Ma'am Patricia. May mga questions na tayo.
Yeah,
diba?
Actually, gusto ko yung acceptance is the key.
Okay.
Even the situation that we have now, wala tayong pupuntahan but to accept what we have now. And
okay,
from here, move on.
Yes,
normal.
Exactly.
That's what we're doing with all full CBA. But before that, let's call on, she's back, ang aming campus administrator from Quezon City Campus. So we would like to hear some inspiring words from our Dean Salazar.
Thank you, Ma'am Patricia Mauricio.
Thank
it
you.
Was really inspiring. Yes, as what you have said, everyone, not only you students, but we also, the leaders, the middle managers, and the faculty members of Our Lady of Fatima University, we are adjusting to the new normal, as what they are saying, because we should not stop what we are doing and what is our dream in the future. If we have the goal to finish 2 or 3 or 5 years from now, we have to continue with it because Our Lady of Fatima University is very much open for all the privileges to all their learners. One of the privileges is that the forwarding of the balance from the previous sem to the next semester, because they understand the financial challenges of your parents, of your siblings, and your guardians. And then they also had the partnership with the scholarship. Like, for example, the Bukas PH, which is open to all students that are 18 years old and above. It is already open to all campuses now, not only in Quezon City, but all campuses. So you can apply at Bukas PH. You can see their website. You can see their website and you can apply there. What the Bukas PH will offer is that, let's say, for example, I'm giving an example, like in the BSA in the second year with no SOST, your tuition fee is 23,816. You can apply all of this, the entire school fees for this semester, and it will be given to you by Bukas PH with a 1.5 to 2% interest per month, but it is payable in 10 months. Payable in 10 months, what you need to do is just go to their website and then register for the application, accomplish the application form. And then within 72 hours, you will get the response from them. In 10 months, meaning kung 23,000 yan, let's say there is a 1% interest, the 23,000 might be monthly, it's roughly 2,000. 372, something like that, 2,372 within 10 months. Apart from that, we have also partnership with a non-government scholarship foundation. That's the Simplicio Gamboa Foundation. They also give scholarship to the Fatimanians. What you need to do is just communicate with our admissions office. Miss Charisma Santiago is the one responsible for this. You just give your application and then she will facilitate your application. The Simplicio Gamboa is giving out 15,000 per semester until such time that you will finish your degree. Another is, of course, from the government, we have the SYDP from our Quezon City government. And of course, if you still wish to apply to the UNIFAST of CHED scholarship, you just communicate with our admissions office. Ms. Charisma Santiago will facilitate everything, communicate with the admissions office. You may never know, maybe you will be the one who will be chosen or prioritized to be the recipient of the TES, the Tertiary Education Subsidy from UNIFAST. And they are giving out 60,000 per school year, that means 30,000 per semester. So there is no hindrance if you wanted really to finish your degree. There are many possibilities and many assistance from the government or from private institution and even within the institution, giving you a big discount for your tuition fee or for your school fees coming semester in an installment scheme with forwarded balance. And if you are fully paid, there is a credit of 1,000 tuition fee. Thank you, everyone.
Okay. Yes, din, lahat po yan i-cover natin later as our one of the panelists will go in to discuss the scholarships and tuition fee later. Thank you so much din for giving us those information. Din, may nakakatawang mga shout-out tayo. Live na live kasi tayo sa Facebook. So binabati natin si Idel Juris Alcantara. Good luck po and God bless to CBA Quezon City. At meron po tayong shout-out kay Nathan Beray, My School. Wow, very proud daw siya. My School. Yeah, your school, Quezon City Campus. Thank you so much, Din. Dean. Maraming salamat po. Ma'am Sheila, meron ka ba bang gusto sabihin kay Dean?
Thank you so much po.
Ma'am Sheila.
Thank you for sharing those information. And ako din, may pa-shout out dahil live tayo, Sir BFF. So may mga students tayo na online right now and watching with us. So sila Jason Barca, sila Neris Ilustre, no? So mga naka-online po sila, i-share po nila ang ating link, no? So para marami pa pong ma-inform na mga students. So going back, Sir BFF, to our industry speaker at yung mga hanging question po ng ating mga students. Sir BFF.
Hi, Ma'am Patricia. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Ma'am. Sorry. Going back to you, Ma'am. Meron po tayong two students muna ngayon na mag-ask live para sa kanilang question. Mr. Joshua, can we request na, can you open your video so we can see your face para makita namin ang kapugian mo, Joshua?
Hey, sir. Joshua, wala po akong camera, pero may naman po ako.
Bye.
Mic naman po ako.
May microphone
sa computer po eh.
Sayang hindi namin masisilayan ang mga gumawa po eh. Ng Quezon City. Oh, Joshua, anong itatanong mo kay Ma'am Patricia?
Hello?
Joshua, naka-mute ka. Naka-mute ka. I-unmute mo.
Hello po?
Yes.
Okay na po. So,
yes,
hi Ma'am Patricia, good afternoon.
Hello.
In your experience in the Human Resource Department, particularly recruitment, how does the pandemic affect your operations and how do you respond to the new normal in the way you hire employees and on the job trainees?
Okay, that's really a good question, no? Very relevant
to
what's
nice
ever happening now. So, basically Joshua, before, right now kasi I'm catering Australia. I'm part of a multinational company in Australia. So everything was actually, prior the pandemic, everything was all virtual. So sabi ko nga kay Ms. Sheila when we were discussing, I told her, you know what ma'am, parang very relevant, no? Kasi bago pa nag-pandemic, I'm already practicing whatever we should be doing right now. Because in terms of recruitment, although before, in all the BPO industries here naman in the Philippines, they're also practicing yung mga ganitong, let's say, we do interviews via Skype, we send off the questionnaires via email, so paperless kami, ano? Pero right now, with my job, what I'm currently doing is everything would be virtual. So I do phone screenings via Skype, I do interviews via Zoom, I do collect the documents of the candidates, scan copies via email, and then I forward it to the higher management that are located in Australia. So, you know, Joshua, if you're telling me if I'm affected of this pandemic, siguro I would say no, but I feel like, kasi as I've mentioned earlier, no, with regards to the job or the employment, maraming trabaho na available. It's a matter of how you sell yourself. It's a matter of, you know, kasi even mga ibang mga aplikante, we don't really check on the qualification. Sometimes, mas maganda yung skill set and the personality of the person. So if you're telling
Correct.
Me, let's say, if you're thinking or you're about your question is about the qualifications or paano kami naaapektuhan, I don't see any problem with that at the moment. Siguro, with the Philippines, lalo na syempre mga Pilipino, we can really cope up with this situation. And kayang-kaya naman natin gawin mas higit lalo ang ginagawa ng mga nasa ibang bansa. So yun. I hope I've answered your question.
Opo.
Okay ba?
Thank you, Joshua, for that question. Ma'am Sheila.
Yeah, actually, meron din ako. Tama yun, no? I agree on how you sell yourself, especially with online learning.
Correct.
And Fatima, flexible learning.
Correct.
Ang competitive advantage na yun ng mga students natin. No? So,
yes.
From Ms. Jessa Garingalaw, Ms. Jessa and Garingalaw, meron din siyang gustong itanong kay Ms. Patricia. Okay, on naman yung camera mo. Ms. Garingalaw. Ayan.
So, can you say that flexible or blended on the job training can give student trainees the same skills learning as compared to the old normal?
Wow.
Okay. Wow, very ano yung question
oh,
ha.
Oh, very.
Kumbaga talagang tumbok na tumbok na yung
tumbok
ano.
Na tumbok.
Yes. Thank you so much for that question, Jessa, no. Well, I would say ako kasi Ms. Sheila and my interns before, they know that I'm a very personal type of person. You know, when I provide training, I see to it na very personal siya. I don't really treat my interns before as an intern. That's mm-hmm. what I tell them every time. Kaya actually, until now, we still have a group chat on Facebook and sometimes we get to chat with each other. Pero, I feel like, syempre, as I mentioned earlier, you know, with the talk that I provided, this is basically the first time that this happened. No, na we have a pandemic and ngayon lang yata mangyayari yung magpo-provide ka ng training ng virtual. So I guess I won't say na it's gonna be the same, no? But definitely, the impact would still be the same. It's how you adapt to the situation. Let's say, for example, you'll be provided a training how to conduct an interview. Definitely, magiging parehas lang yung process pag ikaw, na-adapt mo siya ng tama. And always, ako kasi, I always see to it na, this is my golden rule to my interns. If you have questions, you have to ask me. And then, if you tell me that you know it already, you don't need to ask me questions anymore. Because you already told me, you know how the process works. Ngayon, I always believe kasi the skill set is, you know, it can be trained eh. It can be taught to anyone. Kahit yung hindi nag-aral, pwedeng-pwede mo yung turuan kung paano mag-interview. So I think the training, it's more of the adaptability of the person, how you adapt to the situation, kung paano mo siya inintindi. And if you feel like you don't understand, then there's no harm naman if you ask the question for you to understand it further. Yeah. I guess I hope I've answered your question also.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessa. Shout out muna ma'am tayo.
BFF, may mga
shout
may
out
mga questions pa ba tayo? Oo, mag-shout out muna tayo. Okay. So, una natin shout out.
Shout out kay Jerry Lynn Ondoy and Rachel Ebeliar that's watching Facebook Live right now. Ask in Facebook.
Okay, shout out din kay Idel Jury Alcantara, good luck daw and God bless to CBA Quezon City.
So, and also kay Mark Morales and Syra Gallardo, shout out to you and thank okay. you for staying with us dito sa CBA Connect. Kumustahan?
Okay. Ma'am Sheila, may mga questions pa ba tayo? Okay na ba tayo kay Ma'am Patricia?
Actually, I have one question for Ms. Tricia na galing sa Q&A box natin. May
okay.
May hinahanap, sabi niya, may hinahanap or hahanapin daw ba ng new skills ang mga HR or anyone who's hiring OJTs so that our school, especially our professors or particularly siguro kaming mga SWEB coordinators, can prepare our students under the new normal. Kung may new skills daw ba kayong hinahanap, Ms. Tricia?
Well, as I've mentioned earlier, no, I believe that the skill set is ano can be trained. And ang dami ako mga interns before na hinar na, you know, I wouldn't say naman that they're not qualified, no. Pero in terms of the skill set, I see the potential in the person. That's okay. why I hired them. And right now, I mentioned earlier, I'm very proud that everyone is employed. Siguro, kung hindi man everyone, it's most likely 80 to 90% of mm-hmm. them. And the skill set, siguro, kasi right now with the pandemic that's happening, and before, di ba, previously we had ECQs, I would really just suggest to the students that are watching right now to enhance your skills. Not mainly of everything na siguro, let's focus on the doable things first. Let's say your communication skills, because that's very important. You know, if you're applying for a job, communication skills is very important. So, I would like to inspire the others to, you know, watch good movies that would enhance their communication skills. Or, ang dami na kasing mga resources ngayon, like sa YouTube. ang daming mga demos dyan for you to enhance your communication skills. So, again, earlier I told you can take it one step at a time. Hindi pwedeng pagsabay-sabayin ang lahat. So, if you want to have, right now, I feel like, I mean, I can't really speak to, for the, all the, the companies here, kasi iba-iba naman ang mga qualifications that they're looking for, no? Pero, I feel like in general, wala kaming specific na hinahanap for a student aside from their, you know, sometimes kasi their diploma is very important if they're specifically applying for a job. And that is why very important yan ay pagpatuloy mo yung pag-aaral mo. And then also, regarding naman dun sa skill set, I don't think naman meron, pero I think one factor, big factor talaga is the communication skills because communication is number one. Especially to employer-employee relationship.
Okay.
I actually agree to that, Ms. Tricia. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ma'am Tricia.
Thank you, Ms. Sheila.
BFF, let's say thank you kay Joshua at kay Jessa. Talaga na nag-effort para magtanong sa ating distinguished resource speaker. No? Siguro, magkaroon lang muna tayo ng konting commercial. No?
Commercial.
Meron kami ipapanood sa inyo na AVP na ginawa ng Quezon City Campus para sa kanilang CBA Flex Education Ready. So panoorin natin kung gaano ba ka-ready ang CBA sa Flex Education. Let's watch this! Ng virtual clap ang Quezon City
thank you.
Sa kanilang CBA Flex Education Ready. Siyempre, sa panguna yan ni Ma'am Sheila, ang aking BFF. Thank you very much, Ma'am Sheila, sa pag-prepare mo ng AVP natin ng CBA Flex.
Yes, okay. Of course.
Ma'am Sheila,
yes, sir.
Anong next portion na natin?
Okay, yeah. Having seen the CBA Flex video, meron tayong dalawa actually.
Correct.
Na kasama ngayon na naka-experience na ng flexible learning or online learning during their SOST, no? So last summer nagkaroon po tayo ng special online summer term. So kasama natin this afternoon si Miss Joanne Blanco and si Miss Kyla Villa, actually they're incoming third year ng BSA. So magsi-share sila sa atin ng kanilang SOST awesome learning experience.
Yes, correct. Hi, Joanne and hi, Kyla. Welcome to our Paralets Connect online kumustahan. Kumusta kayong dalawa? So, unahin muna natin si Joanne. Okay lang ba si Joanne unahin natin? O si Kyla?
Nakamute ka, Joanne. Nakamute yung mic.
Nakamute si Joanne. O sige, si Kyla muna. Kyla.
Kyla. Yeah.
Kyla.
Hi, hello
Kyla
po.
How are you?
I'm good, Char.
Kyla.
Thank you po for having me here as Kyla. Part of this webinar.
Yes, actually, may question lang. Would you like to, okay, before we ask you your question?
Nagkakaroon siya ng problema, oo.
Yeah, oo. Mag-share muna si Miss Kyla ng kanyang SOX experience before natin siya tanungin. So, BFF.
So, good afternoon to each and everyone po. My name is Kyla Villa. I'm incoming third year BSA student. I am grateful to be part and chosen to this webinar. So, my SOS experience ay halo-halo yung emotion. Merong masaya ka, excitement. Minsan, merong failure minsan. So, the first experience that I have is yung sa Ulfo email address. Talagang na-stress ako doon kasi I did not receive any invitation sa email ko. So instead of using my email Ulfo email address, I use my personal account to log into Google Meet and in Zoom. So okay naman yung discussions, and minsan sa internet connection, 'di ba? And unstable internet connection, minsan nawawala-wala yung discussions. But of course, minsan yung mga prof din, kasi yung one time I have this professor na nag-brown out sa kanila and we have to reschedule the meeting. So okay naman dahil nagawa rin naman within that day. And third, ang masasabi ko lang sa mga fellow student na mag-enroll ngayong semester is that i-download nyo na agad yung mga files kasi para makita nyo na agad yung outline or yung topic na ibibigay sa inyo. Kasi nga, for me kasi, iba talaga yung experience kapag ka-online class. Kasi iba yung kaba, iba yung pag-intindi mo sa lesson. So, for me, I download beforehand the files and review beforehand mag-umpisa yung mga classes para magkaroon ako ng idea kung ano ba yung i-lesson namin within that day. In connection with that, I would highly recommend to the professor that they will record their online discussion and post it in Facebook page. Because for me, especially in my major classes, I'm struggling with it. So if I have difficulties or there's a vague ideas, I can easily look back to that Facebook page. So para pag-aralan yung mga lessons na hindi ko talaga maintindihan. And fourth is, yung maingay, talagang loud and background noises, talagang ire-ready mo yung sarili mo na may maririnig kang manok, mga aso, may mga nabibidjoke. So, dapat ready ka sa mga ganun.
Master pack yun. Online.
Totoo. Diba? Live na live ka eh.
Kasama yes, talagang aso at manok.
And at syempre po na-appreciate ko rin naman po yung mga professors na nagjo-joke sila sa online minsan kahit na hindi siya masyadong connect nakaka-connect yung mga student kasi nga iba yung feeling kapag online. And lastly, I consider Canvas as part of my social life. I consider kung paano mo bisitahin yung Facebook mo, yung Instagram mo, yung Twitter mo, dapat ganun mo rin bisitahin yung Canvas mo dahil nandun yung mga activities, mga files na dapat mong ipasa dahil may mga deadline ito. At syempre, andun din yung mga files na dapat mong kunin. So overall po, I am so happy na naging part ako ng e-learning na to dahil as a student, gusto ko rin makagraduate on time, have a decent job, correct, at makatulong din sa pamilya ko. Yun lang po.
Okay. Kyla, dyan ka lang muna ha, kasi may mga konting interview questions pa kami sa'yo eh. Ma'am Sheila, introduce mo yung ating second SOST student.
Yeah, actually, another SOST student na mag-share ng kanyang awesome experience. We appreciate that you tell everyone, no, na i-inform, kasi hindi naman lahat parang syempre roses and all the flowers, no. Yung meron ding mga parang so yung mga connectivity and all. So thank you for sharing even yung mga negative, no, ng online learning, kasi mm-hmm. parang i-ready niya. And to add more, no, do sa sharing na yan, si Miss Joanne Blanco naman ang mag-share.
Okay.
So, hello po. Hi, mga CBA.
Hi, Joanne.
Hello po sa mga CBA QC. So, my SOS experience is very different from face to face, no, sa actual. Syempre nasanay tayo ng papasok, then vacant, then uuwing pagod kasi mahirap mag-commute at napaka-traffic, no. So, dito sa ano na to, but the good thing is, ang pinaka nagustuhan ko dito sa online class na to, pagkatas ng klase, nasa yun na yung oras mo. So, pwede ka nang kumain, pwede mo nang gawin yung gusto mo. Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Continue.
Yun. So, during class naman, nakakatuwa kasi yung pati yung parents mo na nakikinig din, no? So, minsan nga mas excited pa si mama kaysa sa ano ko, sa klase ko, di ba? Minsan siya pa yung nagre-remind, uy, may klase ka ngayon, anong oras na, ganyan. So, namomonitor ka ng parents mo sa pag-aaral mo. Then, natutuwa sila kasi kahit nasa bahay ka lang, ay, nagiging productive ka.
Correct.
So, tinuruan ako nitong special summer online class na maging self-discipline, no? So, habang quarantine nun, so, di ba, nag-a-alarm ako nakokontrol ko yung sarili ko na mag-social media, no? So, maging productive, mag-aral kaysa gawin yung mga mag-i-score mo lang yung time mo, mag-aral ka, ganun. So, huwag tayong matakot mag-adapt ng pagbabago, no? Natutuwa ko dahil sa system natin ng Canvas. You know, sa ibang school, walang ganito. Available yung mga modules, no? Nag-enroll ako dito kasi katulad ko, mga irregular student na hihirapan kami dahil I came from different school, no? May pagkakaiba yung mga subjects. So, para makahabol kami, binigyan nila ng opportunity yung mga irregular student na makahabol. So, napakaganda nitong summer online class na to. At para din makatulong sa mga working student, no? Yun.
Okay.
So, napaka-flexible. Ayun lang.
Thank you, Joanne. Joanne, may tatanong lang ako sa'yo tsaka kay Kayla. Hi, Kayla. Pwede bang balik ka uli?
Yan.
Kayla, oo, may tanong lang ako sa inyo. Siyempre, sinabi, awesome experience daw ng SOST. So, pwede nyo bang ibahagi sa amin kung ano yung pinaka-the best SOST moments nyo together with your class, online classmates, and online professor, and online banding. Lahat online, di ba? Lahat virtual. Can you share us your best SOST moments? Siguro nahin natin si Kayla. Kayla, ano yung best SOST moments mo?
Siguro po yung best SOST moments, yung sa EDEV ko na class, yung nagpa-activity si sir na lahat talaga, lahat kami nagsagot doon, sabay-sabay. Pero kahit sabay-sabay, nainak naman ng mabuti na ibigay yung tamang sagot doon sa tinatanong, at sobrang saya kasi lahat talaga nakikipag-participate.
Parang extra, mala extra challenge to kasi yes. Paunahan makasagot, tama ba?
Yes sir.
Okay. Si Joanne, ano naman ang iyong best SOST moments?
So sa akin naman po, yung doon sa class namin kay Ma'am Sheila, habang nagre-recite, biglang nag-brown out. As in, mismong nagre-recite ako na nag-brown out doon. Pero pagkatapos... Ayan. Pero pagkatapos naman noon, naayos naman, and in-approach ko po si ma'am. So, thankful din ako sa mga professor natin kasi napaka, ano nila, maintindihan nila, no? So, sinabi ko ganun nga. So, naiintindihan nila yung mga situation ng bawat estudyante.
Okay. Ma'am Sheila, may tatanong ka ba sa dalawa nating SOST students?
Actually, kasi, Sir BFF, they were my students sa International Business and Trade. Yeah.
Kaya naman pala.
And they're very active in our class discussion kasi every meeting talagang I make it a point na engaging yung aming discussion.
Correct. So engaging and interactive.
Sila. Lagi silang nag-recite. Siguro lang, no, last question for the both of them. Although may sinabi na naman nila kanina, pero ano yung mga other tips na maibibigay nyo, no? Kasi yung iba talaga first time lang nila mag-enroll ngayong first semester.
Oo, okay. Sila na-experience
na
nila.
Ano yung parang tips para makapag-prepared sila sa online class?
Correct. Siguro si Kayla uli. Kayla, ikaw uli muna.
Siguro po, dapat alam mo kung ano yung mga subjects mo. Kasi, sa communication din po sa online using Messenger kasi minsan hindi mo alam naglalesson na pala sila, so kailangan meron kang communication sa mga kaklase mo rin, sa mga professor mo, and of course i-download mo na agad yung mga files para alam mo na, para mabasa mo na agad, para hindi ka mawala dun sa lessons. Yan po.
Okay, thank you Kayla. How about you, Joanne?
So ayun po, 'di ba, bago pagka-enroll mo, malalaman mo na 'yung schedule mo, no? So dapat gumawa ka ng scheduler, no, para malalaman mo kung ano 'yung oras mo, kasi syempre nasa bahay ka, minsan hindi mo mamamalayan na 'yung class pa pala. Then 'yung yun nga, 'yung maging active ka sa Messenger mo, 'yung Gmail mo lagi mong i-check, tapos maging aware ka palagi kung 'yung mo, 'yung mic mo naka-on, kasi baka mamaya napakaingay nung nasa bahay tapos naka-on pala 'yung mic mo, 'di ba? Tapos yun nga, aralin mo muna 'yung mga lesson kasi available naman 'yung mga resources and modules sa Canvas natin. So okay. Siyempre, kailangan mong aralin kasi di naman mo wala yung active participation sa online. Kasi katulad dun kay, sa class namin kay Mrs. A, no? Meron pa rin, recitation, ganun.
So, recitation pa rin, pero wala lang 500 words. Meron pa ba ang 500 words sa requirement?
Sa meron. Hindi mo essay.
May essay pa rin, no? Hindi pa rin pala makakawala, no?
Opo.
Okay, thank you, Joanne. Siguro bigyan natin ng virtual applause si Kayla tsaka si Joanne. Palakpak naman natin. Okay, maraming salamat sa inyo, Kayla and Joanne.
Thank you for sharing your SOST experience. Sir BFF, shout out muna tayo sa ating
mga online viewers.
Viewers.
Correct. So binabati natin lahat ng online viewers natin sa official Facebook page ng Our Lady of Fatima University. At lahat din po nanonood na students natin na nanonood ng live sa CBA All Foo official Facebook page naman ng CBA at nanonood ng live sa CBA Connect natin. So tatlo ang pwede nilang panooran, Ma'am BFF. At yes, Syempre, ang pinakagusto nating pasalamatan din ang ating distinguished industry speaker na si Ma'am Patricia Mauricio. Ma'am, thank you po sa inyong time.
Thank you.
Pinaulakan niyo po ang aming invitation kahit na po ataw dito during this time of pandemic, talagang prosigido kang magbigay ng idea at ng iyong thoughts sa ating mga online viewers. Ma'am BFF, may gusto ko bang sabihin kay Ma'am Patricia?
Yeah, thank you so much, Ma'am Patricia, for your time and for sharing your insights. I'm sure na-boost yung aming mga graduating students at even yung mga naka-graduate at even yung mga students ngayon. Magiging ready sila for the new normal in online learning. Thank you so much for
correct
sharing.
Siguro sa thank sinabi you ni Ma'am Patricia, lalong ma-encourage ang mga students natin na mag-continue na mag-aral ngayong semester.
Yes.
Kasi sabi nga ni Ma'am BFF kanina, your dreams cannot wait, di ba? Your dream job cannot wait. Thank you so much, Ma'am Patricia. Siguro bigyan natin si Ma'am Patricia ng isang virtual clap. Palakpakan natin si Ma'am Patricia. Thank you, Ma'am Patricia. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for having me.
Okay po. Okay, Ma'am BFF, siguro Pumunta na tayo sa pinakaabangan na portion ng ating mga students. Pero bago tayo pumunta sa Q&A portion, I will introduce all our panelists one by one. Okay? This time, ma'am, BFF, ano ka muna sa pag-host mo at pag-co-moderator ko? Kasi magsasalita ka later. So ako muna, ibigay mo muna yung floor sa akin. So let me introduce to you our panelists for today. And these panelists will go in to answer all your questions. Number one panelist, our BSA program head, Ms. Joanne Marie Uy Santos.
Okay? Hi, good afternoon.
Hi, Ma'am Joanne. Okay, next. Second panelist natin is the BA program head, Dr. Elna Barantes. Hi, Doc. Hello, Doc. Okay.
Hi, good afternoon po.
Good afternoon, Doc. Ang ating pangatlong panelist is the SWEP coordinator, Ms. Sheila Marie Apostol. Hi, Ma'am BFF. How are you? Kumusta ka dyan?
Oh, ma. Hello. Hello po sa inyo lahat.
Pahinga ka muna sa pag-moderator mo kasi kailangan mag-prepare sa mga questions, mga nagbabagang questions sa mga online viewers
natin. Actually, yes, sir. Bumaba ka ang ating messenger.
Oo. Kaya pahinga ka muna dyan. Pag-isipan mo yung mga dapat mong isagot. Okay. Tawagin natin na huli natin yung panelist, JEBC Advisor, Mr. John Christian Conejos. Hi, sir. Good afternoon. Okay. Let's go straight to the question and answer portion. Una po nating question. Okay? Pili ko naka-live na ba? Naka-live na ba si Adeline May Lorenzana? Pili ko naka-live na siya. Adeline?
Yes po.
Yun, Adeline, pwede bang makita namin ang maganda mong face? Hi, Adeline.
Hello po.
Yun, thank you so much at nag-effort ka talaga na mag-online at magbigay pa ng questions ngayon. Adeline, ano ang question natin?
I'm asking in behalf of my friend po, what if okay. Meron pa pong balance last semester and hindi pa po nababayaran? Pwede pa po bang mag-enroll for this
okay.
semester?
Okay, I think that questions will going to be thrown to our program head ng BSA, Ma'am Joanna Marie. Uy, Ma'am!
Hi, ano? Good afternoon. Hi, Adeline.
Hello, Ma'am.
Yes. So, actually, medyo nabanggit na rin to ni Dean Salazar earlier. Yes, kung merong balances last semester, it can be paid during the first sem. So, if a forward lang yon this sem. So, you can enroll with just a minimum of 1,500 down payment.
Okay.
Thank you po.
Thank you. Okay. Adeline.
Sino nga yung next natin na magtatanong para sa ating panelist? Okay. Di siya naka-online pero galing to sa Q&A box natin. Tuloy pa din po ba ang scholarship programs ng OLFU ngayong pandemic?
Yes. Tuloy-tuloy ang scholarship programs ng OLFU. May pandemic man o wala. So, all who offers scholarships and partners with other institutions in providing our students affordable quality education. Actually, in this slide, we only included some of the programs available to our students. We have the OLFU's Foundation Scholarships, which will cover the tuition fee and the miscellaneous fees of qualified students. We also have some students who are recipients of government, NGOs, corporate, and other private institution scholarship grants. Meron ding tayong program for the athletes, no? You just have to qualify for our official team sa ating varsity and you will be able to enjoy a host of benefits. So hopefully, matapos na ang pandemic para ma-enjoy na rin ng ating students ang panonood ng ating mga intrams. Diba? So, eto namang next. Suking-suki dito yung BSA students natin, sir.
Opo, alin dyan, ma'am?
Madami tayong CBA students na pasok sa ating dean's list.
Wow,
so just to share, no.
Correct.
Isa tong proud moment ng CBA, no. Just to share, we have one student na who got an average of 1.0.
Wow.
Diba? GWA, 1.0
grabe.
During the first semester and
parang
second.
Parang rinurulal na yung grades niya.
Actually, naka-ruler.
Very good, ha.
Imagine first sem and second sem.
Okay.
Diba? Dean's list siya. 1.0 wow. Average. So
talagang pasok na pasok. Mga ganito mamo, 100% na to, no? 100 scholarship.
Yes, sir. Okay. So, anda tsaka ang dami rin talaga nating students na nagbe-benefit sa program na ito. No? They are really thankful to OLFU for
yes,
this.
Correct.
And at the same time, they do their best talaga to continue
Oo.
Being part of the dean's list.
Oo, mag-aaral talaga sila kung wala silang kung nahirapan sila ng pambayad ng tuition fee, talaga mag-aaral sila mabuti para maka-discount.
Totoo. So, kumbaga win-win siya.
Correct.
Nakakatipid na si student at the same time, mas nagiging eager pa siya.
Correct.
Diba?
Totoo. Matutuwa pa ang parents kasi matalino na, nakakalibre pa ng tuition fee.
Yes. Diba?
Okay. Ma'am, uwi may second question tayo from our Q&A box. Require required po bang paano po ang installment payment this sem? Sorry, yun po ang question.
Oh, okay.
Paano po ang installment payment this sem?
Yes, sir. So same pa rin last semester, no? So we have plan A and plan B for those na mag-installment plan. So these plans require a minimum installment charge lang. So for plan A, the charge is 400 pesos. So students need to pay 30% of the total fees before the classes start. And then the balance of 70% will be divided into two. So 35% mm-hmm. will be collected prior to the preliminary examination week uh-huh. and then another 35% before the midterm week.
Uh-huh.
Now, for plan B naman, madaming installment lang. So, four installment siya. So, students mm-hmm. just need to pay a down payment of 1,500 to enroll.
Mm-hmm.
So, the remaining balance, that is the total assessment fee minus the 1,500 down payment uh-huh. will be paid in three installments. So, 35% okay. before the prelim, another 35% before the midterm, and the last 30% before the final week examination.
Ah, okay. Ma'am, follow-up question po doon sa tanong from Q&A box. Ano po ang tulong na maibibigay ng OLFU sa aming mga student ngayong pandemic?
Okay. So, kung yung scholarship natin tsaka yung installment plans natin is same-same pa rin compared sa previous semester. So, for this year, for this semester, mm-hmm. OLFU provided the tuition fee credit na tinatawag.
Wow.
So, merong discount na 1,000 pesos. Sino? Yung mga students na nakapagbayad in full for the second semester balances nila.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So instead of paying a down payment of 1,500, they only need to pay 500 pesos.
Wow.
Makaka-enroll na sila. Okay?
But so para sa lahat yung ma'am naka-full payment na ng last sem. So may
yes,
1,000 ano sila. Imbis na 1,500,
500 na lang.
Wow, malaking
yes.
ano yan.
But please take note lang na this is for one-time use only.
Mm-hmm.
So yung mga nag-enroll ng SOST at na-avail na itong 1,000 credit na ito, hindi na siya ma-avail next this semester kasi nagamit niya siya.
Gamit na nila, oh, correct.
Yes.
Okay, next ma'am. Ano pa sunod ma'am?
So, yun.
Yun lang po.
Yun lang po, sir, for
okay.
that question.
Siguro ma'am, last question po. Para sa ating tuition fee and scholarship na galing po sa ating Q&A box, meron po bang student loan program ng OLFU?
Oh yes, medyo napahapayawan din ni Salazar earlier.
Oo.
So actually natuwa ako dito sa program na to kasi bagong-bago to. So all OLFU partnered with Bukas PH which will let our student avail of up to 12-month installment plans through Bukas loan. So the good mm-hmm. thing about this program is that there is no collateral.
Mm-hmm.
So, they just have to apply, which is easier and faster. It can be done online. Also, it can cover up to 100% of the tuition fee of our student at a very low interest of 1.5
wow.
to 2% monthly. So, bukod dun sa installment plan natin, meron pa tayong Bukas PH partner, no?
Partner. Yun ito yung student loan natin. Uh-oh.
Yes, sir. For more info, sir, they can check the Bukas PH Facebook page. Andun po lahat ng links. At the same time, it is also posted sa OLFU's official Facebook page.
Yun. Yung pala, mabilis nila mahanap kung paano sila
kapag
student loan. Yes, sir. Click-click
lang.
Click-click lang, no?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Ma'am, diyan ka lang. Mukhang itong tanong na to na nagpa-pop up sa Q&A box ay para din sa'yo. No? This is about curriculum naman, ma'am. Okay. Una pong tanong, hindi po ako naka-enroll sa SOST. Magiging irregular student po ba ako?
Actually, yan yung worry ng mga students natin. No? Lalo na sa BSA, ayaw na ayaw nila yung magiging irregular student sila. Kaso, ang problema, marami tayong student na, syempre, because of the pandemic, hindi naka-enroll. So, to answer that question, Okay. No, if you are a regular student who was not able to enroll in SOST, you will continue to hold this the regular status.
Okay, liliwanagin
natin.
Liliwanagin natin, ma'am. Regular student pa rin sila kahit hindi sila nag-SOST. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Kasi kasing iba, baka mag-i-irregular daw sila.
Nag-worry kagad sila. So, okay. Actually, the college recalibrated the curriculum to cater both types of students, no, yung mga SOST takers and the non-SOST takers. So, for this academic year, there will be separate sections for these two types of students. So, magkaiba yung course na ite-take nila. Courses offered during SOST will be taken by the non-SOST students this sem. So, medyo may adjustment na ginawa, pero regular pa rin sila. Kumbaga, si Olfu na yung nag-adjust.
O at least, di ba, wala na yung agam-agam nila na yes. Magiging ereg na sila at nasagot na yung question. Okay, next question, ma'am. Magagaling kay, nandiyan na kaya si Abby Castañeda. Abby, kasi nagpa-pop up dito na gusto niya mag-question. Siguro nahirapan pa siya makapasok. Sige, next question muna from our Q&A box. May qualifying exam po ba talaga? BSA student po ako. Qualifying exams mo ba?
Yes. So, qualifying examinations kasi is part of the retention policy of the BSA program. Hindi natin siya pwedeng tanggalin. Lahat ng school na nag-o-offer ng accountancy, they have the retention policy. Okay. So, this is given for OLFU. This is given every year to the BSA students prior to admissions to the next level. So, first thing, we have the MQE, the Mandatory Qualifying Examination, which is supposedly to be given to the incoming second year. But however, due to the circumstances, the program announced some changes. Actually, I've already posted this dun sa closed group namin. So, in lieu of MQE, qualification to proceed to second year will be based on the academic indicators. Okay, so, magbe-base na tayo sa grades. So, those with grades of 1.0 to 1.75, automatic yon, qualified na sila sa BSA program.
Wow.
Diba? So, no need to take the MQE. Okay. Good
noted
as fast na sila.
Noted yun, ma'am Uy.
Yes, 1.0 to 1.75. Paano naman yung may grade na 2.0 to 3.0? So, they will be under probation during the first semester. So, during the first semester, we will be giving a special qualifying examination. So it will be announced naman. You will be given time to review, no. Lahat ng may grades na 2.0 and 3.0.
Okay.
So of course, kapag may bagsak sa major accounting subjects, you will not be qualified to continue the program. Now, the second level naman is yung comprehensive examination 1, which is given to the incoming third year. Actually, we just concluded it last week. So congratulations to the 79 students who passed the COMEX 1. So they qualified na for the incoming third year. And then yung last naman is the comprehensive examination 2, which is given to the incoming fourth year, which is wala pa naman tayo ngayon sa new curriculum.
Okay. Thank you, Ma'am Uy. I think naka-online na si Abigail Castañeda. Abigail, how are you? Abigail?
Hello,
Abby. Oh, yan. Hi, Abigail. Balita ko, meron ka daw gustong itanong kay Ma'am Uy. Ano yung question mo?
Apo, regarding po sa laboratory class, paano po yung magiging system kung wala pong face-to-face classes?
Okay, magandang tanong yun nga, ma'am. Anong magiging setup natin yung mga laboratory class?
So actually, as mentioned earlier, we recalibrated the curriculum. So for this semester, the college cannot offer the laboratory classes kasi nga mahirap mag-assume kasi hindi pa natin alam kung ano yung mangyayari bukas. So there will be no laboratory class offering for this semester. So first sem courses with lab units is divided into 2 sems. Halimbawa, we have, diba, ACTG 121, which is 2 units lecture and 1 unit lab. Or say ITAB 211, 2 units lecture, 1 unit lab. So the college will offer the 2 units lecture this semester, then the corresponding 1 unit laboratory will be offered next sem. So mahahati siya.
Okay.
So that's how we recalibrated the curriculum. Kasi we are not sure kung magkaka-physical class this first sem.
Okay. Ma'am Uy, meron tayong pumasok na question from the Q&A box from Anonymous. Attendee daw. From Kaurine Aurelio. Hello po, ask ko lang sana if may SFA na po.
SFA?
Student Financial, tama po ba? Dean, baka pa rin tayo matulungan ni Dean. Dean.
Yes, kay Dean Salazar.
Dean, anong masasabi po natin? May SFA na po.
Okay. For now, yeah, the SFA loan will still continue. But for now, the application haven't started yet.
Okay.
But it will still continue. The SFA, we are just trying to collate all those that had applied previous semester. But it is an assurance that it will continue again. You can just send your email at sfs_qc@fatima.edu.ph.
Okay.
sfs_qc@fatima.edu.ph.
Okay.
For your intention to enroll in SFA.
Dean Salazar, sorry, may tanong pa po para po ata to sa inyo. From Luis John Jr. the second Soreta. Tanong niya po, salamat po sir, nasend na po ako ng reg card. Ang problema po, double po yung sub-PTI po section. Ang nakalagay po sa units ko, 53 units.
Yeah, actually, I'm looking for this. I'm answering kasi one by one in the question box. I'm typing my answer. Yeah. Kindly, John, kindly send your registration. Or I'm going to look for your registration card after this because I have my off-site connection. I will check and then I will just resend an email to you.
Wow, grabe. Baka
na, na double entry ka siguro dito. No, because I'm doing enrollment off-site because I'm vulnerable. But I can attend to this, John. That's why I wrote your name. Because I'm going to correct na double entry ka nito, John.
Okay.
So I will resend your email and I will resend your new copy of new reg card tomorrow.
Okay. Grabe, John, ha? Si Dean Salazar pa talaga magre-reply sa'yo. Ha?
Thank you,
ang
po,
campus,
Dean.
Ang campus administrator natin ng Quezon City.
Hindi, kasi enrollment officer din ako. Eh.
Wow, grabe. Dean, na talagang multitasking ka din. Ha? Okay. Thank you, Ma'am Joanna. We thank you very much. Siguro nasagot mo naman lahat ng mga tanong natin from our Q&A box. Let's proceed sa ating mga questions naman tungkol sa curriculum. No? Ay, okay na pala tayo sa curriculum, no? Sa enrollment naman tayo. Okay, mga questions naman natin for enrollment. Siguro ang makakasagot diyan si Sir Best. Sir Best. How are you? Sir Best. Oo. May tanong tayo from our live audience. Unahin mo natin yung tanong ni Alisa. Alisa, nandiyan ka ba? Hi, Alisa.
Yes po.
Hi, Alisa. No, pwede po ba namin makita yung magandang mukha?
Hi po.
Oo. Alisa, anong question mo para sa enrollment?
Sir, ask ko lang po kung paano na po yung process ngayon ng enrollment. And kailangan po bang magpunta ng school? Required po ba?
Okay.
Ganito. For the enrollment process, the students needs to have an initial down payment of 1,500. After paying their initial down payment, the students are required to take a picture of the receipt. Then, after taking a picture, the students can proceed to use the link for the Google form. The students are required to upload the photo of the receipts of their initial down payment. And the students are required to answer all the informations needed by the Google form. Then they need to click the submit. The Google form informs the students if the enrollment process is successfully. After that, the registrar office, they are the one who send the registration card to the students.
Okay. Alisa, okay naman ba? Nasagot ba naman ni Sir Best yung tanong?
Opo, sir. Thank you po.
Thank you, Alisa. Thank you so much, Alisa. May another question tayo, Sir Best, from Catherine Bellio. Catherine?
Hello po. Good afternoon.
Hi, Catherine. Good afternoon. Thank you sa pag-join sa amin ngayon sa CBA Connect. Anong question natin for Sir Best?
Tatanong ko lang po kung halimbawa po magbabayad po kami ng tuition fee. Ano po pwedeng mode of payment noon? Tsaka saan po pwedeng magbayad? Kasi po one time po nagbayad po yung friend ko po sa Dragon Pay po. So under po ng Dragon Pay is yung sa bayad center po. Tapos nung nagpunta po kami sa cashier, para pong, ay sa registrar po, para pong pinaklarify muna po yun. So tatanong ko lang po kung sa Dragon Paper, kaya sa bank po, mga ilang banking days din po yung ano.
Ah, okay.
Para po makredit po siya dun sa account.
Okay, ang tanong yung mode of payments natin, yung mga payment options.
Okay. The students can pay their tuition fee through school cashier, but make it sure that you are 21 years old and above. Mm-hmm. And if you are 20 years old and below, you are not allowed to go to the school.
Okay.
But the students can pay their tuition fee through banks like UCP, BPI, PS Bank, but it is exclusive only in Lagro branch. But you can also pay your tuition fee in Metro Bank and East West in all branches. The students can also pay their tuition fee in Dragon Pay, and they can choose what type of merchant they use. For example, the 7-Eleven, the Bayad Center, Cebuana, Palawan, LBC, M. Luelier, and etc. And through Dragon Pay, the students can pay through online banking transfer. And then, dun sa case niya, meron kasing ini-email yung Dragon Pay na confirm na nag-access sila doon sa Dragon Pay, and then yun yung ipapakita nila na dun sa babayaran nilang pinili nilang merchant. Kasi nandoon yung reference number na ipapakita nila para i-accept yung payment nila.
Okay po, sir. Thank you po.
And then after, okay. After kasi na makapagbayad na kayo doon, makaka-receive ulit kayo ng confirmation galing kay Dragon Pay na in-accept na or confirmed na yung payment ninyo for your tuition fee. Then yun yung ipapakita nyo na katunayan na bayad na kayo for the down payment.
Sir, after po nun, pwede po dun sa enrollment, dun na lang din po namin isi-send yun, sir. Sa, yung sa enrollment form po sa Google Form.
Yes. Yes, please, yes. Screenshot nyo siya. And then,
upload. Yung
isa, dun sa ano, i-upload nyo siya. And then, pwede na kayo makapag-proceed doon sa pag-enroll sa Google Form.
Thank you, sir. Thank you po, ma. Thank you, Dean.
You're welcome.
Thank you po.
Mute ka, sir. Nakamute ka, sir. Sir JR.
Yung mic mo, Sir JR.
Sorry. Yon. Sorry, nakamute ako. No? Again, thank you so much, Alisa and Catherine, sa inyong mga questions. May mga questions ulit tayo sa Q&A box. Tungkol naman to sa online delivery modalities, para naman siguro to kay Doc Barantes. Doc, may dalawa tayong students na naka-online ngayon, magtatanong. Beb Giganto, CJ Beb, anong question natin?
Hello po. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, CJ.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon din po sa mga kaklase ko na nanonood ngayon ng live na to, because yung tanong po kasi is para rin po sa lahat. I have a lot of friends na incoming first year, and meron din pong mga ngayon po nakatulad ko na magiging third year rin po na hindi po kami nakapag-experience ng SOST. And we don't have knowledge kung paano po ba ma-access ang Canvas.
Ayan. So magandang tanong yan. Kung sa pag nagta-travel tayo, like in a bus, in a plane, so kailangan natin ng ticket. Di ba? So for the first semester, ang kailangan nating ticket is our Fatima Gmail account. So mm-hmm. This is an exclusive Gmail account given to all students ng Our Lady of Fatima University. So nakpersonalize siya, whereas ang gagamitin is yung first name, initial ng name ng student, and it yung family name nila, and it is naka-address siya at student@fatima.edu.ph. So lahat ng estudyante is given this Fatima Gmail for free. Okay?
Wow.
So ano ang laman ng G Suite? So this is under Google, na merong meron tayong tinatawag na Google Apps. So under the Google Apps, doon natin makikita yung Canvas. Ibig sabihin, hindi na natin kailangan ng isa pang email address para maka-access ng Canvas, as long as you have your Gmail accounts. So included also in the Google Apps, nandun na rin yung mga resources na meron ng OLFU, like yung Learning Resource Center, nandun na rin siya sa loob ng Google Apps. So ibig sabihin,
iisa lang ang kailangan nilang Gmail address in accessing all the apps na gagamitin ng All Foo in the first semester. Diba? Pack na pack. Wala nang kailangang maraming login.
And
okay ba? May tanong ka pa ba, CJ?
Ano po, ma'am? May kaklase po kasi ako, ma'am, na nagkaroon po ng problema yung Gmail account niya po. For example po, may letra po na hindi nasama. Napapaayos pa po ba yon? Or yun na lang rin po yung ang gagamitin nila?
No, actually kasi, since nagkaroon ng updates ang Gmail, maraming student ang nagkaroon ng problem in the access. So ngayon, Elite and the G Suite team is working on that, and they are making sure that before the semester starts, naayos na lahat ng access ng mga students.
Okay.
So for concerns about that, you can send email to G Suite at help center nila or sa Elite, or you can ask assistance from Sir Conejos and program heads ng CBA, so we can assist you.
Okay, thank you Doc. Bago tayo mag-proceed sa next question natin, shout out muna tayo kay Sir Ellery Reyes for answering the question via FB Live. Thank you, Sir Ellery. Talagang support na support siya sa CBA natin, no? CBA Connect natin. Okay, next question, magagaling kay Queenie Mutia. Queenie?
Hi po.
Hi, Queenie. How are you? Good afternoon.
Good afternoon po.
Hi,
Queenie. Yes, anong question natin, hi, Queenie?
Po. So, yung question ko po is, dahil nga virtual learning is the new normal po, what to expect po sa virtual meeting na magaganap?
Okay. Ayan, so since the government has declared na walang face-to-face classes during the first semester, so Our Lady of Fatima has designed its classes in a pure online setting. So meron tayong tinatawag na synchronous and asynchronous classroom setting. So pag sinabi natin synchronous, this is the time where the students and the faculty will be meeting virtually. So anong ibig sabihin ng virtual meeting? So ito yung time na i-invite kayo through an app. So most likely they will be using a Zoom or a Hangout to meet with you to discuss topics or classes. So ito yung gagawin in a synchronous setup. So sabay-sabay yung isang buong section na mag-meet together to discuss a particular topic, or dun yung time na i-discuss, i-raise ninyo yung mga concerns ninyo on the topics with the teacher. And then, meron din tayong tinatawag na asynchronous. So, ito naman, students are given yung own pace nila in learning. So, di ba, kung babalikan natin yung message kanina nung mga naka-experience ng SOST, dito na develop na kailangan i-develop ng student yung kanilang self-discipline. Kasi at this time, walang teacher ang magbabantay sa inyo on how are you going to answer activities. So, ang main na platform or ang LMS na gagamitin ng Our Lady of Fatima University is the Canvas. Diba, sabi nga natin kanina, in accessing the Canvas, you just need to have your own personal Fatima Gmail account. So doon sa Canvas, all the materials, module, lessons will be uploaded, including activities, quizzes, exams, pwedeng may discussion. So everything will be uploaded in the Canvas. So going back doon sa kanina, di ba, sa message ni Kayla ba yun or ni Joanna, di ba nagbigay siya ng suggestion na kung po pwede ba daw i-record ang mga lessons. Okay? So the college is now on designing a flexible working worksheet or a flexible learning worksheet wherein students will not be required or meetings will not be required synchronously. So there will be weeks na hindi kayo mag-meet virtually, but instead you will be watching a recorded lecture on a particular topic. So ito yung ginagawang preparation ng college ngayon. So for us to be able to save yung internet load natin. So hindi na kailangan parating mag-discuss online. So through the recorded lecture, you can hear or you can watch doon sa video yung lesson or yung discussion ng teacher ninyo. O, di ba?
Okay. Grabe, talagang pulido ang pagkaka-explain ni Doc Barantes. Doc,
kasi
thank you so much.
Kasi preparation na ginagawa ng college for our students.
Thank Very you good. Po.
Thank you so much, Doc. Thank you, Queenie.
Thank you.
Thank you, Queenie. Okay. May next questions po tayo. So bago tayo mag-proceed, thank you kay Queenie tsaka kay CJ. CJ, tsaka Queenie, thank you so much again. Okay, may next question tayo para naman sa SWEP. Okay, nako, ma'am BFF, para talaga to sa'yo. Okay, from Q&A box natin. Number one question po, offered po ba ang practicum this first semester?
Okay. So good afternoon po ulit sa lahat. And before I answer that question, so ihahanging question muna po natin. Sa SWEP po, I would just like to share with everyone that with the current pandemic, no, COVID-19 pandemic that affected the entire world, especially yung business operations for both private and public sectors. So with that happening, the process of training for SWEP faces a great challenge. Mm-hmm. So tayo kasi responding to the new normal, so sabi nga natin acceptance is the key. So, and to continue to provide the best training for our future young professionals, for our future business and entrepreneurial professionals, no? CBA together with all FU and all of our industry partners, no, will provide blended SWEP training or practicum training, no? And this is how we respond to the new normal, accepting the scenario that we have now. So with the SWEP blend training practicum, may expose pa rin naman yung mga trainees with the industry virtually, no? And we develop guidelines. This is formulated by the SWEP coordinators across campus in coordination with the program head and of course our dean, si Dean Cordova. Now, shifting to the flexible learning or work from home or online. So we have made arrangement with industry partners. So actually, currently, we are continuing making arrangement with industry partners. Yung mga SWEP forms will still be available online. So maa-access siya. And there are revisions that we made in the SWEP manual na adapted, no? Nag-adapt kami ng mga provisions to the new normal. And in lieu of the student training monitoring, because we do that as part of our student training monitoring and industry visit, magiging virtual yung student training monitoring. And we also made addendum or provisions, COVID-19 provisions for the memorandum of understanding in case na maghanap or merong tanungin kami ng industry partners na o meron tayong ganon. And of course, we will apply the credit hours system. So ano ba itong blended practicum program natin for our on-the-job training? So we will have actually 30%, so 30-70 to. We will have the 30% flexible practicum micro-training series and 70% will be the shared learning exposure. So, anong mangyayari sa 30-70 na practicum alternative that we came up with? So, yung 30% na flexible practicum micro-training series will be composed of webinar. Okay? So, may mga webinar. We will, the student trainees or yung mga OJT, they need to attend webinars which are related, should be related to their field of study or specialization. And they will need to submit a certificate of attendance or evidence that they attended the webinar, and they will need to provide documentation. Now, attending the webinar, again, that's part of the flexible practicum micro-training. Meron kami din na pinrepare ng mga sub-coordinators across campus na tinatawag namin on-the-job training skills learning checklist. So, ibabangga natin yung documentation na isasubmit nila doon sa checklist na yon. Now, another flexible practicum micro-training series will be research paper or case study. No? So, ito din, relevant to the current situation ng industry. So, ipoprovide. May training, may checklist ulit yon na ibabangga namin para dun sa credit hours and yung skills learning na ina-expect natin na makuha pa rin nila. Another practical micro-training series is the reflections no, of yung mga employers na nag-ooperate during the landscape nila during the pandemic. Siguro yung ginagawa nilang response, yung recovery nila, and yung gagawin nila in the future para to survive or pagka nakabalik na tayo sa next normal or yung new normal. So going to the shared learning na 70%, so ito naman yung mga participation of our students sa JEBC. No? Sa, meron tayo kasing JEBC Summit, meron tayong JEBC Congress, meron din tayong International Study Tour for CBA. So kasama yan sa sa training, shared training exposure ng OJT. May credit hours din tayo dyan. Magsasubmit din sila ng certificate of participation or evidences nila. Another is for working students. No? So if we have working students na mag-OJT na, meron din tayong mga criteria na makakredit yung hours nila, no? Provided that they will comply with the necessary requirements. Another is the volunteering. Kung nag-volunteer sila sa mga charitable or NGOs, or even kasi mag-showcase yung kanilang leadership skills, work ethics, yung kanilang ability to adapt in a work environment. That can still be considered as part of the shared exposure, no? So, okay. Yung 70% okay. Na sinasabi natin. So, pwede din makredit yung hours nila doon. Okay. And lastly is yung remote internship na tinatawag natin, mm-hmm. where they can work independently at home. No? So, we will make arrangement with industry partners for them to be provided with the task that they need to complete for the whole week. So, meron silang worksheet na gagawin, may task na i-assign sa kanila, and they will make a report completing the number of hours for the independent working at home. So, next will be how will be the process flow for SWEP. No? So, yung tanong kanina na mag-open po ba, actually, part ng process flow is we conducted a survey of the students who have the intent to take their on-the-job training. Actually, summer nga meron eh, no, for the curriculum. By the way, yung curriculum po ng ating SWEP or practicum is old curriculum po ito. So, kasama po dito yung fifth year na BFA okay. program. Uh-huh. And majority of the enrollees for OJT are fourth year irregular.
Okay, so, ma'am, follow-up questions. Sorry to disturb you, ma'am. No?
Yes po.
Follow-up questions daw. Ilang subjects po kami allowed i-enroll kasabay po ng practicum?
Yes. Sabi po natin kanina sa intro natin, their dreams cannot wait. So, i-open po natin yung practicum to answer the first question. And for the second question, ang nasa student handbook po kasi is they are allowed to enroll 6 units na subject together with practicum. So, yun po. Pero marami po akong nare-receive na email na, Ma'am A, pandemic, mahirap po, working student po ako. Baka po pag next sem, ma-extend pa po ako, hindi ko na po kayanin. So, mai-stop po ako. So, given the situation that we have now, and flexible nga ang tawag natin eh, we might be considerate for those who have more than 6 unit subjects, provided that they will meet the criteria. So, may mga okay. requirements pa rin po tayo that they need to comply. No? Okay. So, pag na-meet po nila yon, like, writing a letter of a subject for approval, i-highlight po nila doon yung mga subjects. And of course, yung mga schedule, if the course is offered, no, that's another concern. Okay, ito pa yung number of subjects na naiwan ko. But are they offered? Hindi. So, kung graduating ka, they are allowed to take tutorial. And okay. it's their last semester. Para lang makagraduate on time, no, within their okay. time frame ng graduation.
Sorry, so, ma'am, BFF to cut you.
how many subjects, yon. Meron tayong nakuha na intent to enroll their on-the-job training from summer and then first semester, kasi may summer grad,
okay,
yung first semester. Yun na lang talaga yung iba eh. Yun na lang yung subject nila eh. Yung course that they will take on OJT na lang, no? So,
okay,
from the process flow, so i-assess if there are credit hours na ibibigay sa kanila. Baka mamaya may utang pa ang SWEP, no? Kasi mula first year, sumasali na siya ng Congress, no? Ng nag-study tour pa, and so on and so forth.
Oo, ma'am, Sheila, sorry to interrupt you, no? Siguro lahat ng question talaga yung ganyang kapulido na explanation. Siguro they can really go to your office for any clarification, no? Okay.
Yeah, we will have a SWEP orientation to address all their concerns, no, SWEP-related. Meron ang orientation natin, usually General Assembly, no, face-to-face. But with the new normal, online orientation magkakaroon. And we also proceed with the recruitment interview simulation.
Okay. Ma'am, naka-live po ngayon, nakapasok po sa dashboard natin si Claudine Kaalim. Hello, Claudine.
Hello, Claude.
Po. Oo, alam ko may question. Hello, ka, Claude. Claudine,
yes,
anong,
po, sir.
Anong question natin?
Question ko lang po. Paano po mag-apply for credit hours kapag nag-participate po sa mga college events and activities like Congress po?
Okay. That's a good question. Ma'am BFF?
Yeah, actually, as I mentioned earlier, no, part ng shared learning exposure yung participation. So, meron tayong, sasabit nila yung kanilang mga proof, no, yung certification nila and documentation, i-require. And then, merong in-approve si Dean na prescribed number of hours na i-apply doon. So, kunyari 360, kunyari lang, no, example, 360 hours siya, nag-join siya ng JABC Congress, kunyari 50 hours yung i-credit, kunyari. Tapos, nag-join pa siya ng International Study Tour, kunyari 100 hours yon. So, meron na siyang credit na 150 hours na ili-less doon sa 360 hours mo, Ms. Kaalim. Kasi marketing ka, di ba? So, 360
yes,
hours yung kailangan mo. So, ili-less natin yung lahat ng credit hours mo. So, whatever is left, yun na lang yung i-re-render mo hours.
Okay, malinaw na malinaw yun. Thank you, Claudine.
Thank you,
Alisa. Thank you, Patricia. Thank you, Joanne, Kayla, and Jasmine. Ma'am BFF, feeling ko ikaw may karapat-dapat mag-introduce ng ating susunod na magsasalita para sa kanyang closing remarks, no? Ma'am BFF? Hello, Ma'am BFF.
Hindi ko masyado, sorry, nag-lag. Ano pa, paulit po ng question?
Actually, tapos na tayo sa Q&A, ma'am.
Lag niya kasi, sorry po.
Yan ang gustong-gusto ko sa'yo, Ma'am BFF. Talagang ready ka sa mga question at lagi ka may answer.
Thank you so much for all the questions, for all the students na nag-raise ng kanilang mga questions. And mga, at this point, Sir G, narinig na kita, hindi na nag-lag. No, I would like to introduce, of course, no, at this point, yung aming program head, no, si Dr. Barantes, to give us more additional insight or...
Wala, mag-closing remark na ako.
Oo nga.
Hi, Doc.
Additional insight.
Close, hi, Doc. Nako, kailangan si Dean Salazar. Later, ready rin po kayo ng kahit mga konting insights.
Nag-enjoy ang lahat. Nag-enjoy ang lahat. Para kayo nilang tapusin yung ano. Okay, so in behalf of the College of Business and Accountancy, Quezon City Campus, our heartfelt thanks to Dr. Caroline Enriquez, our university president, for her tireless effort in finding ways to continue education even in this time of pandemic. Our campus dean, Dr. Ramonita Salazar, for gracing our invitation even in a short notice. Our college dean as our technical expert for his endless effort and support for the college, for the encouragement. To our resource speaker, Ms. Patricia Mauricio, for giving us the insight of what is happening in the industry. Our dear students, guest students, Ms. Joanne and Kayla, for sharing their SOST experience. So it gives encouragement to those students na nag-aalala for the next semester.
Correct.
To our energetic moderators, or JR, maraming salamat.
Thank you so much for inviting me sa Quezon City Campus. I hope makakadalo ako next time dyan para makita kayo lahat. Lalo-lalo si Dean Salazar. Hi, Dean.
To all the students who raised their questions sa mga panels and those who joined us in our Facebook Live, so thank you for sharing your afternoon with us. So we hope we are able to enlighten your concerns and help you decide to enroll in the college. So we hope to see you in our virtual classes. So sabi nga kanina sa message ng ating resource speaker and ng mga moderators natin, so let us not stop to pursue our dreams just because there is pandemic. But instead, let us continue to enhance ourselves and continue to develop for us to be more than ready to the challenges this pandemic will give us. Thank you and magandang gabi po.
Hindi ka masyadong ready niyan, Doc Barantes, no? Talagang, hindi pa ready, Bambi FF, no? Ako naman mag-introduce sa magbibigay ng siguro ng final thoughts about this event, no? Dean Salazar, may ano po ba tayo? May final thoughts po ba tayo sa nangyari nating online kumustahan ngayon? Hi, Dean! Hello, Dean!
Thanks. Hi, can you hear me?
No. Yes, loud and clear.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Mark.
Hello, Dean.
Then see.
Medyo nagkakaroon siguro ng problema sa connection. Oo, ka-connection si Dean.
Can you hear me?
Medyo ano po tayo din, medyo malabo pong ating signal ngayon, Dean. Yan. Try mo ulit, Dean. Ulit, isa pa uli. Hi, Dean. Hello. Okay.
Mamaya na lang daw si Dean.
Mamaya na lang si Dean. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Okay. As we come to terms, that all of us globally are facing this health crisis, there is a greater sense of togetherness, di ba? Speaking of togetherness, nagsama-sama ang ating mga university administrator, syempre sa pangunan ng ating university president, kasama ang mga college deans natin at syempre mga faculty members natin para makabuo ng isang magandang solutions at solid reason why we must push the school opening this August. Correct ba, Best BFF?
Yes, and with the COVID-19 pandemic though, that continue to affect our lives, this is the time that we need to be more connected. We need to engage more to adapt to the new normal. To aid learning, OLFU and CBA will be moving classrooms to online for you to stay relevant, keep informed, and learn from home. All online because learning never stops.
Okay, this time we must say experience, excellent education with OLFU and CBA at your fingertips. Keep updated and stay connected with CBA Connect.
Again, in as much as we wanted to entertain all your questions, and dami sa Q&A chat box, no, sa mga nag-Facebook shout out. Alam ko, dinner time na, yung iba baka magsasaing, o yung iba baka mamamalengke pa lang. Okay, so reserve na lang yung mga questions.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you very much.
Good evening po.